What's up, guys? You're welcome to Emacom TV. In today's episode, we'll be looking at CJN Onnoghen must face trial, APC insists. APC, the ruling party, has finally come out and insisted that Onnoghen must face trial. Onnoghen, yeah, that's the Chief Justice of Nigeria, is the Chief Justice of Nigeria. He is currently facing trial on, you know, asset declaration issues. When he declared his asset, he did not declare his entire asset. So a whistleblower came out and revealed that Onnoghen is still having asset which he has not declared, and which to me, it is actually an offense. Yes, I was very blank on this. Is actually an offense. As a public office holder, you should have declared your entire asset. But where the federal government got the entire, you know, the entire thing wrong is there, the federal government now taking Onnoghen to Code of Conduct Tribunal, you know, to be tried is also an error. According to the Constitution, he should have been reported to National Judicial Council. They are the appropriate body to handle such kind of matters, and if need be, they will prosecute him, or they will recommend him for prosecution to Code of Conduct Tribunal, but not the federal government charging, you know, the Chief Justice of Nigeria. He is the face of justice in Nigeria. You know that in Nigeria we have three separation of powers, and which the justice, I mean, judiciary is one of them. So in that department, or that separation of power, should be given that respect. So now APC is coming hard on Onnoghen and insisting he must face trial. So let's see. Says APC says PDP too quick at defending corruption. The ruling All Progressive Congress APC has asked the People's Democratic Party to allow the law run its course regarding the prosecution of Chief Justice of Nigeria, Walter Onnoghen. This is the man, he's the Chief Justice of Nigeria. At a news conference Monday in Abuja, APC wondered whether there is an unholy alliance between the PDP and the Chief Justice of Nigeria, accusing the PDP of always being quick to defend corruption. Following the notice of the charge preferred against the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Walter Onnoghen, by the Code of Conduct at the Code of Conduct Tribunal, People's Democratic Party has been an overdrive, vituperating over an issue that should at least be left to the judiciary to resolve. While we will not want to be lured into discussing issues that are presently before the court, and for which any respectable political party hoping to hold position of responsibility should restrain itself, we regret to suggest that the PDP attempt to hoodwink Nigeria into believing that there is a political motive behind the allegation brought against the CJN might itself be indicative of some unholy alliance, APC spokesman Balabulari Isa Onigo. Your campaign council, a catalogue of who is corruption, PDP tells Buhari. APC said the likely affinity existing between PDP and a section of the judiciary is further accentuated by the non-appearance of Justice Onnoghen for the Code of Conduct Tribunal on Monday, in line with the suggestion made by PDP governors from South on Sunday. Are Nigerians expected to see this as a mere coincidence? Is the PDP and their governor acting a script? Haven't we missed an opportunity to show confidence in an institution headed by the CJN, the party queried. Speaking further, the ruling party said, this becomes more worrisome, knowing that the PDP's campaign have been receiving a cold shoulder everywhere they have gone to, and it has become apparent the party and its presidential candidate are facing imminent defeat in the February 2019 election and may be searching for some unorthodox means of forcing itself on Nigerian people. If this were not so, the PDP should, before coming to this distracting conclusion, have taken cognizance of the fact of the allegation made against the CJN and its admission to the fact so stated. The only logical conclusion in the circumstance is that realizing the refusal of Nigeria to allow the deception of the people, PDP condemning to returning the party to power, the opposition party has alongside some pliable human rights activists devised a plot to distract the APC and indeed the good people of Nigeria from addressing the very important issues on APC manifesto in electioneering process. We have also noticed the very dangerous attempt to designate the CJN arrangement along ethnic and religious lines, thereby trying to heat up the polity by revoking primordial sentiments, which will do the country no good. This is an unholy plot. When we consider that the CJN was an officer of the Federation rather than of any region, we therefore urge all Nigerians of good conscience to caution the PDP, as the country is bigger than any political party or interest it represents, and nothing should stop the country steady march into sustainable democratic governance. Although PDP has some rep candidate alleged marginalization of the constituency, in an earlier statement on the CJN's CCT trial, we had noted the PDP shocking and innate proclivity to defend cases of corruption anytime it arises. The call by the PDP Sousa governor for the CJN boycott of the CCT trial further cements our position. Let it be reiterated that nobody, no matter how highly placed, should be above the law of the land. We wish to put on record the virulent attack that has come from the PDP in the wake of the trial of the CJN over alleged false asset declaration is particularly worrisome and suspicious, when the PDP has in fact called for the removal of virtually all heads of government arms, particularly the chairman of Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, and Inspector General of Police over frivolous issues. So I'm going to put the link to this article on the description so that you can have a full reading of this article from Vanguard Nigeria. So you can see here that the man here, Onnoghen, that's the Chief Justice of Nigeria, he is having a very serious backing from South Governor and some Southeast politicians as well. So we see here that he had earlier boycotted, Code of Conduct Tribunal, summoning today to appear before it. Rather, he had a legal representative representing him, stage a protest to CCT, that is Code of Conduct Tribunal, to air their grievances against summoning Chief Justice of Nigeria, and that due process should be followed. According to them, if the Chief Justice of Nigeria had aired, he should have been referred to National Judicial Council too, which is, to me, personally myself, I feel this is what the federal government should have done. So, but why the haste? Why did the federal government so hastily, refer this Chief Justice of Nigeria, which is the face of justice in the country? He should have been given that proper respect as representing judiciary in the country. Of course, we know we have three separation of powers, and judiciary here is the very second, so he should have been given that respect, and according to the constitution, he should have been referred to National Judicial Council for disciplinary action. So what do you think? Do you think the federal government have erred in this case? Do you think the APC is actually right in insisting this man must face trial Or do you think that altogether that the both APC and the federal government are sabotaging the constitution? Because it is made clear, it is so clear that even the blind could even see it, that it is stated that the Chief Justice of Nigeria, upon erring on anything, should be referred to National Judicial Council. What's your mind on this? What's actually your take on this? You can drop your comment below. Do you think that the federal government can actually win this case following a due process? Or do you think the federal government made a mistake? Let me know. You can drop your comment below. And also, if this is the first time of coming to my channel, you can actually hit that subscribe button below this video and click on the bell icon to get our latest updates on any article, I mean video, news, you know, celebrity, just another information like that. So please, your subscribing to us is a way of supporting us, for us to keep up the good works. So if you support us, just simply click on that subscribe button, and God will really bless you. Good. Thank you very much.